In nature, there are no straight lines. That's mankind's doing. Trapped by gravity, heads down, except for the rare few. But what of the rest of us? Can we also finally be untethered? Perfectly weightless at will? Soaring from place to place? Riding gentle curves in the sky? How would we live then? Would we appreciate this new perspective as an open invitation to create, to connect to a better future, and all that is natural around us, and all that is better within us, to explore more and live our lives with greater purpose? We say yes.
Everyone, please give a warm welcome to Archer co-founders and co-CEOs, Brett Adcock and Adam Goldstein.
Welcome to the Maker Unveiling event. Today, we'll be introducing you to sustainable air mobility, and we'll be revealing our full-scale electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft called Maker. Thank you. Yeah. Before we start, I think it's important to discuss why Archer is doing this. Like, why are we building an electric aircraft, and why this matters to us? Our mission here at Archer is to advance the benefits of sustainable air mobility. We are seeing record CO2 emissions, with the transportation sector as a leading cause. Within cities, we are seeing unprecedented traffic congestion. And we believe there's a really important problem to be solved around this congestion and sustainability. We have an amazing product to show you tonight, which I think will help change the world.
So we're here today at the Hawthorne Hangar in Hawthorne, California. And many iconic aircraft have operated on these runways. This is a place where transformational technologies have been pioneered. And that's really why we're here today, to talk about one of those real-world hard problems that we need to solve. Every aviation revolution has been enabled by advancements in propulsion technologies. And as electric propulsion has continued to advance, we are now enabling electric flight. And we are now on the cusp of a new golden age of aviation, something that we haven't seen in 100 years.
Today, half the world lives in cities, and the UN projects that by 2050, 70% of the world will live in cities. We just have an amazing amount of people living in cities. And in these cities, we live in three dimensions. We live in apartment buildings, and we go to work in skyscrapers. But we travel every day on the ground two-dimensionally. And ground infrastructure can no longer keep up with these populations. It's causing unprecedented congestion. We haven't seen transportation innovation for decades. We still travel around cities the same way we have for the last 50 or so years. And we are bandwidth constrained on the ground. And even moving to a fully electric automobile won't fix the traffic problems that we're seeing. We here at Archer want to unlock a new way of traveling, one that lives in the third dimension and has almost infinite scaling potential. Who hasn't sat in traffic wishing they could just fly over all of it?
Every new transportation solution has really changed the way we've lived. It's also transformed our cities. From the wheel, to the train, to the car, each innovation has allowed us to live just more freely and to travel further. Decades of advancements in electric power systems have enabled this electric revolution. And energy density in batteries have been steadily increasing over the past 20 years. This last decade, we saw cars become electrified. And now, nearly every major auto OEM has announced a complete transformation to an entirely electric fleet. But as energy density continues to rise, we've now crossed the point where we can enable sustainable aerial mobility. In our lifetime, all forms of transportation will go electric.
So we took these advancements in electric power systems that Adam just talked about, and we used it to help fight traffic and sustainability by building an electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, or something called an eVTOL. Along this journey, we had to solve some really hard engineering problems. The first, we had to design an aircraft that could be used without a runway. So our aircraft takes off and lands vertically so we can fit them into the fabric of cities to make it easy for people to get to. We had to move from mechanical systems to fully digital. Most smaller aircraft today are still maneuvered around manually. We designed the entire aircraft to be controlled by software. In fact, Maker has over 90 components on it that run software on it today. We also needed batteries that could be safe in the air and also extremely power dense for our vertical takeoff and landing missions. We have enough power on board as an equivalent to a Tesla Model S Plaid, going from 0 to 60 in 1.9 seconds. These aren't your grandmother's batteries. People have made fun of the concept of electric aircraft. A major news outlet even asked us if this was an anti-gravity machine. I guess, kinda. We've solved these problems, it works, and we believe it will help change the world.
All right, so who's gonna use this service? Well, we think everyone. And in order to have a real dent on sustainable transportation, we really had to make the service affordable for everybody. We want to impact everyday trips, trips to work, a weekend excursion, or even flying into the city, grabbing dinner, flying home. Let's talk about a couple examples. Let's say you live in Fort Lauderdale. You just got invited to the hottest tech party of the year, hosted by Mayor Suarez. You got to go to that. But that 23-mile drive can take you 70 minutes. That's just brutal sitting in traffic. We can fly that mission in under 14 minutes. Or let's say you're here in LA. You're in downtown. You want to go to Santa Monica, grab lunch. That 15-mile drive can take you almost an hour. We can fly that route in under 8 minutes. Because it's actually not that far, we can do it for under $40. There are millions of trips like this. People are taking them every single day. We can move those trips to the air and do it in a fully sustainable way.
All right, so here's a visual of trip data that's happening today in Los Angeles. There's over 50 million daily trips. And of this, over 5 million are taking over an hour. LA commuters are losing almost 100 hours per year stuck in traffic. Like, we need to solve this. Internally, we have a data science project that uses this trip data to better understand how to build the most ideal Archer network, making the service available to everyone. And we call this project Prime Radiant. We use Prime Radiant to better understand where to put takeoff and landing sites, what to charge for the service, and ultimately how to save people time in their commute. For takeoff and landing sites, we're using existing real estate with light retrofitting. That includes helipads and others such as rooftops, land parcels, and parking lots. We get excited not just about the trips we're seeing here, to and from work, to the airport and back, but how about all the trips that we can't do today because they're taking too long to do in a car?
So what Brett's talking about are these urban air mobility missions, right? Your commuting trips. But we think there's actually a broader purpose here. What about all the trips that you wish you could take, but you just don't because they're too far? Imagine you could go anywhere within a 50-mile radius. Where would you go? What if you could go rock climbing on a Thursday in a remote area? Just go after work. Would you go? If you get there in just a couple minutes? Or what if there was an amazing restaurant on top of a mountain and you could fly there in just a couple minutes and it just had incredible views? Today, we're really just limited in our ability to explore because of these time constraints. But this transportation solution, it just goes beyond commuting. Humans are naturally curious. Archer is using technology to help people break away from the screens, really just get back in touch with nature. Archer will connect people with the experiences that they want to have, get them out of that daily grind. This is the era of the micro explorer. tonight. This is Maker. What do you think? So Maker's our full-scale, two-passenger demonstrator aircraft. And its purpose is to serve as a certification testbed and also to help us keep pushing our key enabling technologies. So this aircraft is a result of a really large group of people that have come together across many different disciplines, including flight physics and avionics and structures and many others. And we're so excited to show you the vehicle here today. So let's talk through a couple of those key engineering features that will enable the urban air mobility market.
Maker was engineered from the ground up for the urban traveler. This means designing a new aircraft that can fit into the fabric of cities. In order to do this, we had to design an aircraft for record safety and low noise. We also wanted to make sure that this was a service that everybody could access, which means it needed to be a high throughput network. From a vehicle engineering perspective, a big enabler for us is distributed electric propulsion. Instead of using big turbine or piston engines, which are extremely complex, we are using electric motors, which are much simpler and more energy efficient. Electric motors can be scaled down to enable a new type of aircraft to be built, one that has many motors and high energy efficiency. What we're doing here could have never been possible before. As we designed the aircraft, safety was our number one goal. First, distributed electric propulsion allows us to design in multiple redundant electric motors. We no longer have a single motor that's powering flight. Maker has 6 independent battery packs that power 12 electric motors. These motors are distributed laterally across the aircraft wing, as you can see here. During flight, we can tolerate an entire battery pack system failure or 2 motor failures and still fly the mission safely. In fact, Maker has 0 single points of failure. For comparison, most helicopters have hundreds of these single points of failure. Let's talk a little bit about noise. Our aircraft will be operated directly overhead, so it's important that we do not disturb our local neighbors. Helicopter noise is simply too loud today to make helicopters work in a real way across cities. Majority of noise generated from a helicopter come from high rotor tip speeds. The blades on the helicopter are traveling close to 450 miles an hour. Since we are spinning 12 rotors that are much smaller, we can spin them slower, resulting in lower tip speed and much different nose profile, much lower noise. We have designed the propellers on the aircraft specifically for low noise. The propellers spin at low tip speeds, virtually eliminating the loud wop-wop sound that we associate with helicopters today. And during flight, we're going to be traveling at 2,000 feet above ground level. And just for a bit of a comparison versus a helicopter, we'll be traveling at that altitude at 100 times quieter than a helicopter. This is similar to the sound of a refrigerator running. We'll be virtually inaudible in flight. Yeah. And lastly, is we want everyone to have access to our service, which means we need to design a high throughput transportation network. And what that means is we need to travel fast and we need to use the vehicles a lot during the day. Maker's designed to travel speeds of 150 miles an hour or more. We are designing for nominal missions between 20 and 40 miles, and we designed a long-range battery that was capable of much more than this, so we don't have to fully charge after every trip. For our flights, we'll be using around 30% of our battery pack. And the battery is meant to be fast charged while on the ground, which means it only takes about 10 minutes to charge enough before it's ready for the next flight. That means that the Archer aircraft can do over 40 flights per day. This will help unlock a high throughput transportation system for the masses. Adam, can you talk a little bit about how people are going to interact with the aircraft?
Yeah, so when we designed Maker, we thought about the urban traveler. How do we give them an experience that they're going to love? So we thought about, you know, maybe they have a backpack, maybe they have a full set of luggage coming back from a weekend excursion, or maybe they just have a coffee. And so we wanted to work the vehicle into their everyday life and really just give them an experience that'll blow them away. Brett, why don't we pop the doors and have them take a look inside.
Let's do it.
All right, so the first thing you notice is we have gull wing doors. Definitely the most badass kind of doors you could put on any aircraft. There's also a high wing. We did that because we wanted to make the aircraft really approachable. We wanted to make it have this sense of safety and comfort as you walk towards it. Right? So why don't we head on towards the back here. So let's say you're coming back from a weekend trip. There's plenty of room here for a full set of luggage. You could push it right in. Plenty of room, no problem. But Brett, why don't we hop inside? So it's actually super comfortable. And for those of you that are here, we want to invite you guys down after the show to come sit and see for yourself. But you know, these are performance seats, really unmatched to anything in aviation. And there's plenty of leg room. Brett, how tall are you?
About 6 foot tall.
Brett's about 6'2". He's modest. So if you stretch out, plenty of room, no problem fitting in here. And you could easily fit a bag, maybe even two bags. When you sit back, you can see there is a 270-degree wraparound viewing area. We wanted to let you sit back, take it all in, have fun, enjoy the flight, really get to experience that you're flying over everything. You'll also see at the very front of the aircraft, there's actually no flight controls in Maker. And that's because Maker is an autonomous aircraft, even though the aircraft we will bring to market will be piloted. There's also a touchscreen at the front of the aircraft that will give all the key relevant metrics that we could need. Pre-flight check-ins, airspeed, distance to our destination, or even if your ground transportation is there waiting for you. When we designed Maker, we took an automotive approach to noise, vibration, and harshness. We wanted the ride quality to be really smooth, really quiet cabin. We also designed our flight controls to make sure we could have a really stable, smooth flight from start to beginning. All right, Brett, why don't we hop out and tell them what's next?
We built Maker to be a certification testbed and also to advance our key enabling technologies. Today, you're seeing the rollout of Maker. Maker will begin ground tests and then hover flights later this year. We'll then work to expand the flight envelope from hover to full cruise speeds of over 150 miles an hour. For the last year and a half, we've been working closely with the FAA on our certified aircraft, which will be much like Maker, but it'll be piloted and for passengers. We will open manufacturing for that aircraft next year, and we will enter operations in 2024. We also have announced two launch cities, Los Angeles and Miami. So what will this experience be like? We wanted to bring this to life for everybody here today, so we built a flight simulator to walk you through the journey of what it's going to be like using the Archer network in your everyday lives. Do you want to go take a ride?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right, here we go. Possibilities that open up here. It's pretty cool.
Years of hard engineering work has gotten us here. We have, you know, certification and manufacturing as we're gearing up, and really excited to think about making this an everyday use case for everybody in the world.
Yeah, I mean, just looking out the window and just the perspective that you get as you fly over it all, it makes traveling fun. And, you know, it just, you know, I think about the 2D ground transportation grid that was built, right? It's pretty limiting. It's really tough to scale, but we can fly over it all in a straight line, 150 miles per hour. It opens up the amount of possibilities considerably.
Yeah, I mean, if you look back the last 100 years, every new transportation solution we had that made us move faster allowed us to access new places we couldn't have otherwise before. So as we move from horse and buggy to the car, we can drive to further places than ever before. And now as we're flying in the air, 150 miles an hour, point to point,
we'll be able to access new locations that we otherwise couldn't have on the ground in a car. And so we get really excited about how people are going to interact now with cities and beyond.
Yeah, and the way that cities have really, you know, kind of come together, they're very polycentric. You have these mini city centers that are inside these larger cities. So take Los Angeles, for example. You know, we're here in Hawthorne, but there's big communities in Santa Monica, and then in Pasadena, and then in Orange County, right? You have millions of people in each of these little mini city centers, and they want to connect with each other. They want to be able to move back and forth. But right now, it's quite limiting.
I mean, the ground infrastructure in these cities is basically intrinsically limited by the architecture itself. If we think about a tunnel or subway, every new stop that we add, so say we add a 10th stop to a subway, that means 9 stops I have to go to get to the 10th location. The Archer network is driven by a data science project called Prime Radiance, and it'll be a nodal network. We'll have different locations across the city where you can take off and land from. And every new location we add, so in this case, a 10th new stop, will open up 9 new locations that people can access that weren't there before.
Yeah, and just think about the cost of building that ground infrastructure, you know, for traditional transportation. You know, building that 10th subway stop is billions of dollars and could take a decade to build. But the ground infrastructure that we need is actually pretty simple. You know, just take, you know, parking garages, right? They're perfectly located within the middle of these cities. And that's the type of infrastructure that we need. All we would have to do is just lightly retrofit a parking garage with charging infrastructure. And then now you have another additional takeoff and landing area.
Yeah, and as we're coming in for landing, I mean, these are really 10 or 15 minute trips that we're enabling for folks to take in the air, point to point, instead of being able to travel on the ground, you know, taking an hour or more. And we think this will help enable a new generation of travelers and one that can move into the third dimension. And we think this is possible to do in a future that we're excited and inspired to wake up every day to.
All right, well, I really enjoyed that flight. That was a lot of fun.
That was a lot of fun.
All right, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
So we wanted to show you what it's like flying in and around urban environments, but also just giving you the experience of exploring new destinations, right? Just make life exciting, right? We set out to tackle really hard problems, right? It's really challenging stuff, but it's important for us to stay very focused.
When we started, we posted on our website all of our plans, our goals. Our first step was to build an aircraft to demonstrate the capabilities of electric vertical takeoff and landing. And you're seeing that here today with the rollout of Maker. And we're excited to fully demonstrate these capabilities. Our second step is to certify an aircraft that is just as safe as commercial airliners. And for the last year and a half, we've been working closely with the FAA on our piloted 4-passenger aircraft. Safety is our number one goal. And there's a multi-year roadmap to design around high safety. Our third step is to launch commercial routes in cities and integrate autonomous systems for safety. We're excited to have Maker at the forefront of our autonomous capabilities, and we're pushing hard on engineering problems such as GPS-denied navigation and sense and avoid. We announced earlier this year we'll be launching in both Los Angeles and Miami, both incredible partners for us with lots of traffic, ideal infrastructure for landing sites, and communities very proactive to reduce congestion and move to a sustainable form of transportation. Thank you all for joining us tonight for the Unveil. We're excited to have everyone along for our journey. Come on down.
All right, come on down.
Watching for the omens. I've been listening to everything you said. It's been running through my head, locked and loaded. I got the feeling that you know it. Yeah, I've only just begun. I won't stop until it's done. Till you're broken. I'll climb your walls. You got your armor. I see your flaws. So welcome to the fall.